Candlestick Park, a stadium that has housed numerous championship teams, plays host for this NFC matchup between the Chicago Bears and the San Francisco 49ers.
Well, Phil, we've got a terrific matchup at running back. Two of the most dangerous backs in the NFL about to meet, go toe-to-toe. How do you see it?
Well, you know what? It's not always about the quarterback when you talk about NFL games. And here's a great example of it today. The game of football is still about the most physical team wins. And when you have running backs like this, the more physical team will win.
Fakes out the defender right there on the spot. Frank Gore is in the backfield. Gore's handed the football. Trying to establish the run, but there's nothing there here at the start.
Well, they didn't pick up many yards that time, no doubt about it, but that's a bad job by the running back. He picked the wrong side to run to. Nobody was blocked on the side he went to.
Colin Kaepernick under center. Second and eight as they go ground here. Picks up about four. That's a nice, powerful statement as they establish the run at the beginning of this game.
Well, Jim, you're right. I'm going to give the offense a little credit here, but, you know, somewhere, I don't know, maybe the defense might have to put some weights in their pockets. You got to hang in there and make the tackle.
What a nice corner route run by the wide receiver. He fakes the defensive back out. And look at the quarterback. He knows that little move. When he stuck it, he let him out to the corner. Nice throw, nice catch.
Frank Gore is in the backfield. Kaepernick's dropping back to throw once again.
That's a nice route on the outside. Nice throw by the quarterback. Puts him in good position to keep moving and get a first down.
Offense lines up here. Gore drives ahead.
When you're a defensive tackle in the NFL, I'll tell you one thing it means. It means you are one big dude. And that big dude that time didn't move and tackled the running back for no gain.
Colin Kaepernick under center. Third and four. Running to the left side. Throws out the arm. And it's Charles Tillman who makes the play.
Good job that time by the running back getting down the field and picking up big yards.
That was a big gainer. Now it's time to back it up. And they sack the quarterback.
Well, it's just a race against time, isn't it? When the defense blitzes, can you get to the quarterback before he has time to recognize the blitz and throw it to a receiver?
Handoff to the back, slashes to the left side. He gets into the end zone, capping off the long run.
Good job on that touchdown. That puts him ahead, and it's always, of course, better to be ahead than behind.
The 49ers line up now for the point after. And the point after is good. 49ers setting up for the kickoff. Brings the play to an end. Offense lines up here. Now first and 10. Hester's got it on the handoff. In on the stop. Hester's lined up in the slot. The give. Wide to the left. Bringing the play to an end.
Nothing fancy about that, but it's a good run. Gets a first down. Now the offense has three more chances.
They're able to move the chains after that last run.
They'll go shotgun here, trying to work that left side. That's enough for a first down.
You know, when you throw the football like that down the field, you pick up a first down, now you can do anything you want on the offensive side, and you've got that defense guessing.
First and 10, Hester's taking the handoff.
Here comes the training staff as we've got a player down on the field.
I think you can just tell by the body language and the way he's acting, that is an upper body injury. Hope it's not severe. We'll let you know as soon as we find out.
Matt Corte lined up in the backfield.
Challenging the defenders to the right side.
Five, maybe six out of that.
Nice job by the quarterback. Nobody open down the field. He throws it short. It does not get a first down, but it sure makes third down a lot easier.
Down and two. Working that left side. Tipped away.
You're near midfield. It's fourth down. What do you do? I got the answer right here. You punt it. Play field position. Make the other offense drive the length of the field to score.
Bennett's lined up now as a slot receiver. Well, we'll be switching sides with this one. Ball's going the other way.
Well, that's four plays and out for the offense, and that was bad. Bad play calling, bad play, bad execution. Go to the bench and try to rethink what you're doing.
They come to the line of scrimmage. First down. He's going to be swallowed up behind the line.
Good job by the defense. They stopped the first down play that time by the offense, and now they have a good situation.
The 49ers are going to run the Wildcat offense here.
Second and 14.
And that's a big tackle behind the line of scrimmage.
Well, Jim, they didn't fool the defense at all. Second down, you run the football, hoping to make it third and short. Then you lose yards, third and longs. They're hard to get in the NFL.
Gore's split out wide on the left.
Here we go. Ohio! Ohio!
Third and 17. And he was wide open. 49ers in for the score.
When you got a lead, you march down the field and you add on that lead with a touchdown, it's fun to watch the other team. Will they stay patient or will they panic? My bet is they'll panic.
The point after is good. The Bears are ready to return the kick. And he begins his return. Gets out past the 20 and brought down at the 24. Forte's lined up in a single back formation. They motion the receiver around to the other side. First and 10. The handoff to Matt Forte. Running to his right. He's tackled at the 30. The Bears line up in the pistol offense. Matt Forte going to be a tackle for a loss.
That time, I got to blame the running back. He made a bad read. His vision was terrible. He makes the wrong decision, and it cost his team yards lost.
Third and 7, staying on the ground. So three and out. Double tight end formation. That wraps up the first quarter here in San Francisco. We'll be back in just a moment for the start of the second. Welcome back as we begin the second 15-minute quarter of this game.
Forte lined up in the backfield.
Throwing now to his left.
The 49ers turned the ball over on downs.
Well, they don't get it on fourth down. That was, man, that was a quick drive, wasn't it, Jim? That was just bad play calling, bad execution, and go to the sideline. That's where you deserve to be.
Bolden in the slot. First and 10.
He'll fire it out to the left. Kaepernick able to find Mario Manningham.
When you play man-to-man against this receiver, you're going to have a tough time. Quarterback's a good thrower. Really hard for a defensive back to stay with him.
They've got a first down now after that catch.
They've got him behind the line of scrimmage.
Good job by the defense. They stopped the offense that time on first down. Now the defense is in a good situation.
And the give, and he's in for the touchdown.
Well, what a play for the touchdown, and I'll tell you, in the NFL, there's so many good players on offense now, you can never have enough points, so keep padding on that lead. Good job. Good score.
The point after try is in the books. 49ers setting up for the kickoff.
Got a chance to return this one.
Breaks out of that one.
And he's going to give his team great starting field position on that return.
Well, a lot of good things happened on both sides of the football this time. How about that return by the return team? Good job, good blocking. Look at the speed of that guy running. They get the tackle from behind. They stop the touchdown.
On first down, handoff. They're going to run it right.
Able to make the tackle about 2 yards shy of the first.
Always good to have these types of runs. Yeah, it's not a first down, but it sends a message. It shows everybody that you can run it when you want to. And also, it opens up so many other things for your offense.
The 49ers lined up in the nickel.
The shotgun.
Hard to throw over some of these linebackers in the NFL now. They got such good size. If you try to throw over them, here's what happens. These big guys will knock it down.
The jumbo set on the field.
The quarterback got the defense to commit, and it looks like it'll cost him 5.
Encroachment defense. First down.
They'll take that gift from the defense and line up now with a new set of downs. Gains 5.
Power running. A lot of teams in this league don't even do it anymore. This team, they can power it up in there and pick up those tough yards.
Back to the ground. To the right.
There's the tackle, but still, it's enough for the first down.
Nice job that time by the ball carrier. Getting it just past the first down mark. Big first down. Keep the chains moving.
And 10. Matt Forte gets it here. Trying the right side.
Good job on the ground there by Matt Forte.
Good job by the offense. They're in the red zone. They're down by more than 7, but the defense, can you stop them and just give up the field goal try?
So, first and goal to go.
Going to lose yards here.
So many things you can do on first down, and what do you come up? You come up with that play. That was just a bad play call.
Second and 12. They're going to get him here for a sack.
I don't know what the quarterback was looking at. He had to know the defense was blitzing that time. Doesn't make a quick enough decision, and the defense gets there and gets the sack.
Matt Forte lined up in the backfield. Looks to his left.
blocks, and that pass is going out of bounds, incomplete.
Jim, when you get in these situations, there's not much you can do. Third and long, not easy to pick up first downs in these type of situations.
Nickel formation here for the defense.
Ball's picked off. Wonderful job by the defense that time. They stayed after it. And inside their own 20, they finally come up with the play. They get the interception, and they keep the other team from getting points on the board.
Bolden's going to get set in the slot for this snap. Looking to the right side and throwing. Nice tackle.
What a nice catch by the receivers. Getting past the yard markers, makes the catch, and gets a first down.
First down here after the completion. Kaepernick from the gun. Looking for an open receiver on the right. And the tackle is made at the 35-yard line.
Another first down by the offense. The defense is definitely getting fatigued. And when you get fatigued, you cannot think, so look out.
Bolden's a receiver in the slot. First and 10. The 49ers now move the chains. Now they take the football onto the opponent's side of the field.
This is what drives coaches crazy. You make the quarterback throw it short, then you can't come up and make the tackle, and you give up a long game. You got your players in position. That's all you can do. Now it's up to them to make a play.
And the quarterback is taken down.
This defense, they are definitely not faint of heart, are they, Jim? They will bring the pressure. Good blitz that time, and they take the quarterback down.
Throws the pass. On the money. Tackled at the 20.
That's a nice job by the offense there. Get the first down. Keep those chains moving. Give yourself three more opportunities.
Let's see how they back up the big play here. The give to the running back. No stopping him now. That's a touchdown.
This is about as good as I've seen this offense play all year long. Big lead. They don't care. They're still attacking, getting after it, and they score another touchdown.
The 49ers for the extra point. Extra point was good. The Bears are ready to return the kick. They're setting up return. Fakes him out, and he's out across the 20 and tackled at the 21. We've got an injured player on the field.
Well, that looks like an upper body injury, Jim. I think we both can tell that. And now the question is, how bad is it? You just never know. Well, if you want to be a good play action pass team, it's always nice to have a good running game. Make the defense dig in and try to stop your run. When they do that, you fool them. You fake it, you throw it down the field. That's about as easy as it gets.
And he makes the catch just past the first down marker.
When you talk about throwing the football into open space, that's almost always against zone defenses. That's what we saw that time. Good job by the quarterback throwing it in there.
Right down Broadway.
Well, even though they're down more than seven here, the offense down the red zone, it'll be good for them for the rest of this game. Their confidence for the offensive coach if they can punch this in for the touchdown.
That long gain sets them up here on this play. Jams it across the goal line for the touchdown.
I'd say this run by the offense is just, it's arrogance. They just say, you can't stop us. And they lined up and just shoved it down the defense's throat. Nice run there on first and goal for the touchdown.
Lining up now for the two. They failed to convert on the two-point try, so they'll just have to settle for the six. The kicking team now getting set here for what looks like an onside kick. That kick came right at him, and it looks like the receiving team has recovered.
Flip round!
quarterback coming to the line, hoping to avoid being sacked for a third time. And picks up the first.
When you spy the quarterback, what it does, it just makes it easier to throw the football and complete those passes. Less people cover the receivers down the field.
First and 10. Frank Gore gets it here, and he'll try it left. Impressive piece of running by Gore.
Good job that time by the running back. I'm sure he's a little winded after that play. He showed that speed getting out there and picking up those extra yards.
Here they come back to the line after picking up over 20 yards on that last play. Another touchdown to increase the lead.
Well, the offensive line did it all in this drive, didn't they? Here it is on first and goal. Nice job of pass blocking, and the quarterback finds the open receiver for the touchdown.
49ers setting up for the kickoff. He'll have a chance to take off. And they're all over him at the 18-yard line. Matt Forte lined up in the backfield. Throws to the right and complete.
When you talk about the play-action pass game, it's really when you call it. You got to be in a situation where the defense is thinking run, and when they are, do you have the courage, or I should say the smarts, to fake the run and throw the football. Good call that time by the offense.
They're back at the line after that catch for a first down. And the tackle is made at the 41. The Bears call a timeout, their first.
Jim Nantz, that was the old fly route. When we were kids, that's what they called it. See if you can fly by the defensive back. He did that time. Nice throw and catch.
This play set up by the long gainer. Right where it had to be.
Anytime you get in the red zone, you want to punch it in there and get 7 points. They're being dominated today. They're down more than seven. But don't worry about it. Score here and just keep playing.
Here's the first snap after the big play. He's looking to the right here on this throw and sailing out of bounds. Matt Forte lined up in the backfield. Second and 10.
They're going to get him this time.
Well, if your offensive line's not good enough just to stop the pass rush, then you got to help them out. How do you do that? Well, you keep the tight end in, let him be an extra blocker, and you tell your running backs to help out, too, blocking some of these defensive linemen.
Third down. Halfback sent in motion. Challenging the defenders to the right side, and it's incomplete. Just couldn't hold on to it after the hit. This doesn't look good. We've got a player down, and he's in pain.
That's a good job. He's able to get up and get off the field, and my guess is he's going to be okay. A little bit of a scare there, no doubt about it. That makes everybody nervous.
The quarterback is coming to the line, hoping to avoid being sacked for a third time. Running back in motion here. Out of the shotgun formation. Going for the home run. Bears. Touchdown.
Nothing like having a quarterback who has a good arm who can just fire that football into some tight spots. And then it helps when your receiver has got the talent and the courage to go in there and make that tough catch.
They'll get set, looking to convert on this two-point try. Could have taken the one-point gimme. They went for the two, and they are turned away. The 49ers in kickoff return formation. This kick will stay on the ground, avoiding a big return. They bring him down at the 41-yard line. The 49ers offense heads on to the field. Davis in the slot here for this play.
First down and 10.
Gore heading right. Gets past the first wave. That wraps up the first half here in the city by the bay. And we'll be back to San Francisco after the break for the start of the third quarter.
We're back here now in this one where the 49ers lead by 23.
That'll be a touchback, and the ball will be placed at the 20. Now on first down, the third quarter begins with this play. Challenges the coverage and has the completion.
Well, when your team is behind, what do? Just come out there and get a first down. That's a nice job by the offense.
That reception gave them the first down.
Justin Smith brings the quarterback down. Someone's been injured out there. Hold on a minute.
Always hard to guess what the injury is, but and don't like to speculate, but I think it's pretty apparent. It's an upper body injury. We'll let you know when we find out.
Coming up, second down.
Looking to the right side and throwing. Had it for a moment, but the ball is knocked out incomplete.
Good timing by the defensive player that time. He gets to the receiver just as the football is getting there and makes the hit, knocks that football loose.
Matt Forte lined up in the backfield. Interception.
The tackle was made.
I have to say that's just a terrible decision by the quarterback there. He's got to know when you're in a situation like this, you just cannot make that type of pass.
Well, we're anxious to hear the full story on that injury. Let's go down to Danielle Bellini with the story.
Guys, I had a chance to speak with a Bears team official. They're saying it's just a minor injury, so he should be back on the field pretty quickly.
First and 10. Gore is going to secure the handoff. And that's a big-time tackle that keeps them 3 yards short of the first down marker.
An off-tackle run, it's a staple of all offenses in the NFL. And a general rule is you run off the right tackle because he is the power tackle, where the left tackle is the pass blocker.
Kaepernick, in some ways, is redefining the quarterback position with his ability to throw and run the football like we just saw.
Yeah, you know, I'll say this about Colin Kaepernick. If he couldn't run at all, he still would be a very successful NFL quarterback because he has a tremendous arm to go along with those tremendous legs.
That was a big hit by the defender that time. The receiver drops the football. I'll tell you what, I guarantee the next time he goes over the middle, he'll be looking for that defender.
Second down coming up.
He'll go ground, middle.
What an effort and a touchdown.
To me, still one of the most exciting plays in NFL football. A long running play for a touchdown. And how about that one? It had it all in its speed. Good moves, good blocks. Exciting touchdown.
The Bears are ready to return the kick. To about the 9.
What a good job by the kickoff team. The ball's kicked high in the air, and they sprint all the way down there. The blockers can't get set up. Nice tackle. Now they got great field position for the defense.
Setting up in the pistol on this play.
First and 10. Here's the handoff, and they'll run it. Now cutting to the right side, looking for some open space.
Nice run that time. When you run the football like this, over a period of time, it's going to wear that defense out. There's no doubt about it. Nice job by the offensive line.
And he hauls it in.
Oh, there's nothing like a play-action pass. When the offensive linemen make it look like it's a run, the linebackers are all near the line of scrimmage and easy to throw it down the field for that completion.
Lined up in the pistol formation.
They're going back up top.
The throw to the left. Incomplete. Failing to complete that one. So, second down here.
No one in sight has the grab, and they advance the ball onto the other side of the field.
Well, I think we've heard this expression about 7,000 times. It's a passing league, so we all know that. So, you got to be able to throw the football and pick up some first downs.
And now, on first down, they'll go back to the air. Ball's out. This one's going back the other way. Good piece of tackle.
You got to protect the football on the offensive side. When you don't protect it, the way these defensive players can run, you're going to get in trouble, and that time it results in a fumble.
Davis is moved from the tight end position to the slot. First and 10. Kaepernick sells the play fake and looks downfield.
The offensive line did a terrible job that time reacting to the blitz by the defense. They let the defenders come free, and they sacked the quarterback.
For an open receiver on the right. Inaccurate with that one.
Nice job that time by the wide receiver on the post route. He's open, but the quarterback throws it too far and misses him.
Davis moved away from the tight end position to now a receiver in the slot. Just had to avoid the sack. Incomplete.
Defensive coordinators love this situation, don't they? Third and long, they can do just about anything, and it's going to work, and they stop the offense that time.
The defense comes out of the nickel. Colin Kaepernick from the shotgun. So that's not going to get it done here. And the offense is going to turn it over on downs.
It's fourth and long. What do you expect? To always pick these situations up? That's bad game management, bad play call, bad decisions by the coach.
They come to the line, and it's first down. Throws to the right. Very nearly intercepted. It was a jump ball, in essence, for that throw. And in the end, the defense was able to make the play and deny the completion.
In the NFL, it's always about the most physical guy wins, and that time it was the defensive player. Good job.
Count it. Touchdown.
What a tremendous throw by the quarterback that time for the touchdown. What confidence he has in that arm. Small window, very little room to throw that football in there. He didn't worry about it, fired it, got the touchdown.
The Bears for the extra point kick. And it's a fake. He's looking to the right here on this throw. That hurts. The two-point try is denied. They want the football back as they line up now in an onside kick formation. The receiving team has the recovery. Manningham's lined up in the slot, challenging the defenders to the right side. The pass is intercepted. That'll stop the play right there.
Good job that time by the defense. Not being fooled, being in position. When you're in position, you have a chance to make the play. That time they did, they got the interception.
Marshall's lined up now as a slot receiver. First and 10. and he's thrown to the ground.
Nice job that time by the defense getting the sack. The blitz was well timed, and when it's well timed, the offense doesn't have time to react, and they get a good sack.
Reaches out and snatches it. And it's Patrick Willis who makes the tackle.
When a quarterback can run, it usually takes one guy out of pass coverage. Look at the spy that time on the quarterback. That opens up the passing lanes. Good throw and catch.
After the long gain, let's see what they do here. Looking to the right side and throwing. The Bears get a first down.
Well, you get a couple first downs on a drive. It just, of course, it makes you feel good about what you're doing. It loosens up the offensive play caller. And there's nothing like dictating to the defense. I love it.
The offense is set at the line for the first down after that completion. Bennett's got it on a pass that had some heat.
This is where games are won and lost. Once an offense gets down the red zone, even though they're down more than seven, can you find a way to punch it in there for the touchdown and not settle for a field goal?
The ball is jarred loose.
Nice job that time by the offense. Even though they fumbled, at least they were quick enough and smart enough to get it on it right away.
Matt Forte lined up in the backfield, looking for an open receiver on the right. And that's a touchdown, and they inch closer.
The fade route, it's a big part of every offense now in the NFL. We see it here. Look at the receiver. Pins the defender inside. Beautiful throw to the outside. Fade for a touchdown.
How much does this sting? They get the touchdown, but still they fail to get the two.
Jim, I think it takes a lot away from the football team. It was a terrible decision. Now we'll find out if that 1 point comes back to haunt them.
Tackled at the 13. The defense comes out in the nickel. Throws to the right.
That was a nice job by the offense. It just puts him in a better position. Nice little throw and catch.
Gore's lined up behind his quarterback as the single back. He's in the clear. He's at the 50, the 40, the 30, the 20, the 10. In stride, and he's over for the touchdown.
There is nothing like getting a long running play for a touchdown. When you do, you just feel like you're stealing something. It takes good blocks, but most importantly, it takes a talented running back to get it done, and this team definitely has one.
The 49ers with an extra point try on the way. This works out about 40% of the time if you look back on history, and they'll go. So from 2 yards out, they get it across and secure two extra points. 49ers setting up for the kickoff. We'll send them to the 20-yard line. First down here. He's looking to the right here on this throw. They've got him down there.
Quarterbacks love play action passes because the defense, sometimes they're expecting run. You fake it, easy completion down the field.
From the shotgun, challenging the defenders to the right side.
This is a route that's not run enough in the NFL. The corner route, so many times, receivers just go across the field, they go short. But when you make these double moves like that, you get wide open, and what a throw by the quarterback.
And they can't connect.
Well, for some reason, his quarterback likes to keep trying to go deep down the field against this cover two. That's not the spot you want to go. You want to look underneath or right down the middle.
Matt Forte lined up in the backfield. Looking for a receiver on the left side here. The tackle was made, but the first down is picked up.
It's always good when your quarterback is able to deceive the defense with good play-action fakes. That's what did it that time. Look at the quarterback. Nice fake. Defense reacts to the run, and now you throw it over the top for the easy completion.
First down on the way. He'll take the snap, the first here in the fourth quarter. Ball's going to be incomplete. The hit knocked the ball out.
Jim, that pass ends up incomplete because the defender, he just jarred the football loose with that hit. Nice job. Get that shoulder into the receiver, knock that football out, and get it to the ground.
Second down after the incompletion. Eyeing that left side. Makes the catch. Touchdown.
You got to take advantage of situations like this. Not often in the NFL do you get somebody this wide open. Good job by the receiver. Nice job by the quarterback seeing him. And what do you get? An easy touchdown pass.
Lining up now for the two-point conversion. Looking to the right side and throwing. And the pass is picked by Carlos Rogers. They will not find a way into the end zone, so they'll only get 6 points out of the trip. They're lining up for the onside kick. They want to get the ball back. Flag is down. He stacked up at that point. Will decline the penalty and let the play stand. Offense lines up here. Now first and 10. Running back gets it on the handoff. Game of six.
The off-tackle run, it's just what it says it is. You're going to read the tackle's block and decide whether you're going to go inside or outside. Usually, this is the first running play every team puts in their offense when they go to training camp.
Looking for an open receiver on the right.
The defense has got to be a little aggressive here. Your team is down. You've got to attack this offense. You don't want them to get in there and get another score.
They've got a first down now after that catch. And the give to Frank Gore. Slashing to the right side. Colin Kaepernick under center. Second down and five. Kaepernick still has it after some nifty in the promised land. Touchdown.
Nowadays, so many kids, they grow up, they want to be wide receivers. I don't blame them. They're out there, they get to catch the football, they get to score touchdowns, they get to do dances, and you're not really allowed to hit them either. What a job.
The Bears are ready to return the kick. A touchback. Finish in the slot. First and 10. Incomplete, almost intercepted. Setting up here. He's been sacked four times already. What a beating it has been for the quarterback.
Do one thing at a time. Catch the football, then do the next thing. Run with it. He tried to run with it too quick. That's why he dropped it.
He's setting up here. He's been sacked four times already. What a beating it has been for the quarterback.
This drives coaches crazy. They get a wide receiver open down the field on a post route, and what happens? The quarterback just overthrows it.
Nickel formation for the defense here. They fail to convert, and now a change of possession.
Well, anytime you're in the red zone, you want to punch it in and get that touchdown. If they do that, look, they're still going to be behind, but it gives them confidence moving forward.
Quarters formation here for the defense. First and 10. Throws to the right. He had it, but the hit jars the ball loose.
Jim, the offensive coordinator's done a terrific job so far here today. He's got his team winning. They're in the red zone. Let's see how clever he's going to be on this call.
This will be second down. Play action fake, looking to throw. Interception. He's brought down.
Linebackers nowadays are so talented. They can just do everything. They're strong enough to stop the run, but how about this interception? Good job, good reading of the quarterback, and a nice catch.
First and 10. They bring him to the turf.
There's nothing the defense can do. When you talk about a receiver like these guys out there now, and this one in particular, a double coverage, they're still able to go in between the defenders, rise up.
And intercepted!
Nice job of the defense that time. In position, they read the quarterback's eyes, and it led to an interception.
Two tight ends. First and 10. Escaping the pressure. He's looking to the right here on this throw.
Well, these are the kind of throws in the NFL, Jim. You just take for granted that if it's open, you are going to hit it. But the quarterback makes a big mistake, leads the receiver too far to the inside, and it goes incomplete.
Frank Gore is in the backfield. Kaepernick standing back in the shotgun, ready for the snap. Catch is made. Picks up 20. Here comes the training staff as we've got a player down on the field.
Well, that's going to hurt him tomorrow. There's no doubt about it. When you get hit like that, you're going to feel some of that pain tomorrow. But the good news is, I think he's going to be okay. And once he gets a little situated there, I think he'll be back in the game.
And he's going to be brought down.
And his defensive end, Jim, he is some talent. That time, good job, makes the move, shows the speed, and gets around there and gets the sack.
Kaepernick from the gun. And here's the pass, incomplete.
Lots of ways to attack cover two, there's no doubt about it. You can throw it underneath. You can pump fake the safeties, make one of them move, and still throw it deep down the field.
And Manningham's going to get set in the slot for this snap, challenging the defender.
It's getting ugly out here.
Well, it's professional football. I don't want to hear anything about running up the score, rubbing it in. Your job is to stop the other team. It's not the coach who has the lead. So get out there and get it done. And if you won't, hey, they'll just keep on scoring.
Here comes the wide receiver in motion. And they will not convert here on the two-point conversion. Good stand by the defense. 49ers setting up for the kickoff. They'll take it at the 20.
Three.
First down coming up.
He's looking to go down the field here.
And it's incomplete.
I think that's the hardest pass a defensive back has to defend. The long throws down the field. You have to wait to the last second to make your play. That time the defensive back did it. What a play.
Bennett's a receiver in the slot.
Second and ten.
Into the open flat.
Reaches out and grabs it.
Oh, we've got an injured player on the field.
Well, Jim, I know his family's watching, so we'll give all the information we can as soon as we get it, but it looks like it could be a major injury, and I just, well, I hope the best.
Matt Forte lined up in the backfield.
Going across the middle.
He has the grab. The tackle is made, and that's a three and out series for the offense.
The 49ers with a nickel look here on defense.
Marshall makes the catch. Plenty of zip on that throw.
I think the coach took a little risk that time going for it on fourth and short. Fourth and short in the NFL has turned into one tough proposition, but a good job that time getting it.
Pulls it in. What a call and what a catch.
Find a way to score. That's always the mantra with every team when they get in the red zone. If you punch it in here, even though you're down by more than seven, it'll give you confidence for the rest of the game.
There's some shifting around in the backfield.
First and ten, looking to the right side and throwing. Brings it in for the score in the end zone.
Good job by the offensive coordinator calling those plays. Leads to a touchdown. They're just slowly chipping away at this lead. Now can their defense come out and help them out?
Defense calls a timeout. They're going to bypass the point after and try to pick up the two-point conversion. So they get the touchdown, but they go for two and fail to convert.
I'll be the first to say it. That was a terrible decision to go for the 2 points. I'll give the defense some credit, but mainly the blame goes to the offensive play call.
This doesn't look good. We've got a player down, and he's in pain.
That's a good job. He's able to get up and get off the field, and my guess is he's going to be okay. A little bit of a scare there, no doubt about it. That makes everybody nervous.
Frank Gore is in the backfield. Gore is going to take the handoff now.
On his way.
The 20, the 10. What an effort and a touchdown.
Now you know why running backs get drafted high. Because these long running plays for touchdowns, that's what you want. That's what the NFL is about, making big plays. And when you get them in the running game, that's like double good.
Lining up now for the two. Frank Gore gets it here. So they give up the touchdown, but they do not allow the two-point play.
Yeah, good job that time by the defense. So quick and so ready for that play. They reacted very fast. That's why they stopped it.
He's got a chance to return this one.
Able to move past the 20 and brought down at the 23. He's setting up here. He's been sacked four times already. What a beating it has been for the quarterback. They pick up the first down with that reception.
That time it was an easy completion for the quarterback on the play action pass, and it fools the defense because look how aggressive the offensive line is. They sold the play to the defense, and the quarterback took advantage. All you have to do is watch the head of the receiver. When they drop footballs, usually it's because you can see their head move the other way before the football gets there. That's what happened this time, and it's a drop pass.
And now they'll try over again on second down.
It into his body.
Well, Jim, I always say it's about deception when you're playing offense. That time, the play action fake by the quarterback was so good, the defense didn't even see that he still had the football, and he throws it down there for a nice completion.
2-minute warning.
Let's see what they do on first down following that huge play.
Looking for an open receiver on the right, and it's knocked down.
Oh, nice job. That cornerback, he was watching the quarterback. He's all over the receiver, so it was easy for him to knock the throw down.
It's now second down.
To Marshall.
Touchdown.
And what a touchdown there for the offense. The quarterback just fires that football in there. Look at the defenders around the receiver, but the receiver big enough, tough enough to go up in there and make that catch.
They'll get set, looking to convert on this two-point try. Throws to the right. They failed to convert on the two-point try, so they'll just have to settle for the six. They're lining up here for the onside kick. The onside kick is turned away, and the receiving team has it.
First down, offense readying for the snap.
They knock him down behind the line of scrimmage. The Bears come out in the nickel. Second down and 13. He'll fire it out to the left. Tackle's made. Defense now signaling for a timeout.
Good job by the quarterback that time. Makes the decision. Throws it short. It does not get the first down. But I promise you, third and short is a lot easier than having third and long.
Flex round! Flex round! Flex round! Flex round!
Colin Kaepernick under center. Third and six. Kaepernick able to find Mario Manningham. He'll be brought down, but not before picking up the first down.
Well, that was a nice throw by the quarterback that time to get just enough yards to pick up the first down.
Gain of seven.
I think the best thing to say about that play, it's just it gained a few yards, so that's what you do. All plays don't score. Sometimes you just want to pick up a couple yards.
Trying to work that left side. Was going to be made, but he's beyond the first down marker. The Bears have to call one right here, and they do, and they are out of timeouts. He's setting up here. He's been sacked four times already. What a beating it has been for the quarterback.
Nice situation here for the offense. They're winning the football game. Now they're in the red zone. Let's see if they can come up with a play that fools the defense.
And here we have second down.
They give it to the back, and he's running off tackle. Davis is a tight end, but lined up in the backfield for this play. Wow, looks like the defense encroached.
Encroachment, the defense. The penalty is declined.
A lot to overcome here, especially that penalty, and it's third down.
The blowout continues. Another touchdown.
What a job by the offense. So little time left. The drive down the field and score, that just ices the game. Nice job by the whole football team today, but especially on the offensive side.
Well, this works out about 40% of the time if you look back on history. And they'll put an additional 2 points on the board as they convert. The Bears are ready to return the kick. And a touchback. First down here. Airing it out. And it falls incomplete.
That's what you have to do as a defensive back. You got to wait to the last second. Wait till the receiver uses his hands. And once they go up, put your hand in between them and knock that football down. What a play.
Matt Forte lined up in the backfield. He's looking to the right here on this throw. And that ball's nearly picked off, but he dropped it.
I think this is one of the easier throws in the NFL. Don't make the mistake throwing it up the field. Throw it across the field so the receiver can run to it. That time the quarterback leads the receiver way too far on the post route.
Third down and 10. And they bring down the quarterback, and it's a 3-and-out for the offense.
Well, you expect defensive ends to get sacks because they come around the outside. But when you get pressure from the inside and the defensive tackle gets a sack, that's just an added bonus.
Bennett shifted from tight end to a receiver in the slot. Working that left side. It's intercepted! And he's brought to the ground.
Anytime you're backed up on the offensive side, the quarterback's got to be extremely careful, because if you turn it over, you're just giving points to your opponent. That time, a bad decision by the quarterback, and he throws an easy interception for the defense.
He's setting up here. He's been sacked 4 times already. What a beating it has been for the quarterback. Challenging the defenders to the right side. Runs out of bounds.
Well, how about that, Jim? Not a surprise. Down the red zone one more time. They're blowing them out. And this offense has been spectacular. What will they do here? You know what? I think they'll just run it and try to end this game.
Colin Kaepernick under center. First and 10. The quarterback will hand it off. Nowhere else to go, and he's out of bounds.
The defense has got to be a little aggressive here. Your team is down. You've got to attack this offense. You don't want them to get in there and get another score.
Second down. Looking to the right side and throwing. And they score again here to pad the lead.
Well, that touchdown just put the icing on the cake, Jim. Whatever you want to say, because now the lead's too big. Not enough time for the other team to come back. Great job by the offense.
Lining up now for the 2-point conversion. Play action. Could have taken the 1-point gimme. They went for the 2, and they are turned away. Setting up for the kickoff. They're not going to risk the big return, so here's the squib kick. They face first down.
should have had it.
Looks the football in, but the gloves these receivers wear. The rules that you can't touch them, there's no excuse for dropping the football.
And this will probably wrap things up here.
Looking for an open receiver on the right. Brings it in. Ball's loose. And the recovery is made by the defense. There it is. 60 minutes has run off at long last, and this game is finally over. A blowout from the start.